In today's video, we'll change the tires, add a bottle cage and a bottle, also take out some of the cables which I don't really use, and add a light. I'll be reviewing the light, a Raveman CR300 and an Ice Tools toolkit. Hey guys, and welcome to AJ's vlog. So for those of you who are not following me on Instagram, do follow me if you want a sneak peek on my upcoming videos. So in case you missed my Spark 750 video, the link is here. Do check it out, you will see why I've got new shoes for my cycling. These are the Vittoria Morsa series, and they are 2.3 inch tires with a nice wide tread, so I will get good grip on the trail. First, let's change the tires. One of the reasons why I love this toolkit, tire levers are pinned. One of the tricks that you have to learn in this, make sure your name is right where the valve is. So it's easier on the trail to just find it whenever you want. So I have this converter which will help me use a regular Schrader pump. Another one of my favorites is this Michelin pump. It fills rather fast. First tire, ready to go. Now that the tires are changed, let's add a bottle cage because hydration is very important. So I have a bottle cage from Merida, and I've got a bottle and a bottle cage from Merida, and this is going to sit right here. So while tightening this, always remember, never over tighten. Now that the bottle cage is fixed, let's just check out the tool I used to fix it.
The Icetools Amaze 19, my latest toolkit, has 19 different tools. There's a heavy duty Allen keys in 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 8 mm. There's also a 25 size torsion screw, a plus screwdriver, a minus screwdriver, and spanners in 8, 9 and 10 mm. There's also a 14 and 15 size spanner with a 5 and 15 mm tire lever.
So with the removal of the remote lockouts, my front cabling has cleaned up quite a bit. There were a lot of cables here, as you can see, and it's now much cleaner and basically fewer things to go wrong on the trail. And now the Raveman light to help me in my commute.
The Raveman CR300 is a 300 lumen light with a lot of interesting features. To start off with, you have a remote control, instant output, USB charger and an anti-glare design with cutoff beam. Let's open this box and see what is there inside. It may be small, but it feels very solid. This is a metal body, therefore it feels nice solid. So with this lens, the beam should be interesting to see. At the back, you have your charger, charging point, and I guess the remote also connects here itself, and the power button. The mount itself looks interesting. It does not turn swivel fully at 90 degrees, but then there's a little bit of a swivel here, so you should be able to adjust your beam as you need it. This looks and feels quite solid. The build of the mount is quite nice, and the light itself sits very comfortably on it. Let's see what else is there in the box. So you get a remote and a charger cable. There's also an instruction manual and a couple of rubber bands, I guess, for this one. I'll be installing this on my commuter bike so that I can use it at night and show you how the light is. As you just saw, installation is very simple. Now I wanted to show you guys how it is actually on road, but unfortunately it's raining and considering the coronavirus going around, I didn't want to take a chance going out in the rain. I'm sure the light will survive, but I did not want to take a chance with myself. So hopefully you will get another video soon showing how bright the light is on the road. So guys, a quick update on last week's giveaway. I have placed the order for stickers. There was a lockdown, so it was slightly delayed. The orders have been placed and it should be reaching with you guys soon. Guys, a bit of a sneak peek on next week's video. I will be meeting a national champion and get to ride his XC bike. If you want to know more, check out my Instagram next Tuesday in the evening. So until next time, safe ride everyone. We'll be right back.